Dear ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this presentation about the re-evolution and extension of fatigue test data for welded attachments and butt joints. The presentation is divided into 7 parts. After the introduction, I'll start with the presentation of a database for fatigue test data. Next, I will show you how the data from the database was statistically evaluated. Based on that, I will show you the evaluation using 2 common constructional details as an example. Next, I will introduce 2 new constructional details. After the conclusion and the acknowledgement, there will be time for any questions. The presentation is based on a common research project to improve the fatigue detail catalog of Eurocode 3 Part 19. There were involved the Institute of Steel Construction from the University of Aachen, the Steel and Lightweight Structures Institute from the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, and the Institute of Structural Design from the University of Stuttgart. The research was funded by the Industrial Community Research. The main target was the re-evaluation and enhancement of the fatigue detail catalog of Eurocode 3 Part 19 for a future-oriented design of steel construction under high fatigue loading. Turning our attention now to the database. We was collecting papers from the last 100 years and was extracting the fatigue test data for the database. We did not copy any existing database. From my point of view, this is really important, for example, to avoid duplications. The database enables to inquire a selection of specific data. For example, show me the fatigue test data for all butt joints on high strength steel. And with this data, you are able to make a statistical analysis. Not every source was providing all the properties that we was collecting in the database. Properties like the failure criterion or geometrical parameters of the test specimens are not always documented. Things like imperfections are really rarely documented. For most of the data, it is impossible to assign the data to quality levels according to EN5817. However, the specimens was normally welded under laboratory conditions, so we can be quite sure that the quality of the welds was good. Up to now, we have collected about 23,000 fatigue tests in the database. This leads me to the next slide about the statistical analysis. The investigation of different statistical approaches for analyzing the fatigue test data from the database was a big part within this research project. Finally, we were choosing a procedure that meets the requirements of Eurocode Nord NXD. Let me use the graphic to give a short explanation. For the resistance model on the left, we assume that there is a logarithmic linear relationship between the stress range S and the number of cycles to failure N in the finite life region according to Baskin. It should be emphasized that this is a model just for the finite life region. Nearly all the test data in the database is allocated to this region. According to Eurocode Nord, a prediction interval, you can see it on the right side, is used for fractal estimation to derive fatigue strengths with 95% probability of survival. The determined SN curve with 95% probability of survival describes the characteristic fatigue strength. The characteristic fatigue strength at 2 million cycles refers to the fatigue detail category that is known from the fatigue detail catalog. Let's turn now to an example. With help of the database and the statistical assessment, we are able to re-evaluate the fatigue detail categories of specific details. This slide shows an example. The points in the diagram on the left side are showing all known fatigue tests on butt joints with flushed surface. Flushed surface means that the surface was grinded to remove the weld toe. The continuous line in the diagram marks the characteristic fatigue strength based on this data. As you can see, the characteristic SN curve from the statistical analysis limits the scatter field of the test data, and this is exactly what we expect from the statistical analysis. The reference point for the fatigue strength at 2 million cycles refers to the fatigue detail category. The reference point here is 127 Newton per square millimeter. Based on this, we recommend fatigue detail category 125 for this detail. The current classification in Eurocode 3 part 19 is 112. To sum up, according to our study, we can raise the fatigue strength for this detail. Another example is shown on this slide. The points in the diagram shows all the test data in the database for gusset plates. The current classification is fatigue detail category 45 in Eurocode 3 part 19. Based on our study, we can recommend fatigue detail category 56. The analysis of this detail also show that the chamfer and the angle of the chamfer of this detail are without influence on the fatigue strength. This is may surprising, and I'd like to expand on this point. This detail describes the fatigue strength in the as welded condition. For welding this detail, it is important that the welder is able to weld around the front end. For weld preparation, there will always be a vertical cut at the front end of the gusset plate. So the local notch area for rectangular gussets and gussets with chamfer looks exactly the same. By the way, this is not so easy to implement in an FE model. The examination of geometrical influences based on the notch stress concept, for example, may give a wrong impression of the geometrical influences on the fatigue strength. Again, this is only valid for the as welded condition. For gusset plates with grinded weld toes, the fatigue characteristic differs. However, based on our study, we can recommend an improved fatigue strength. Let's turn now to a detail that is completely new for the fatigue detail catalog, the so-called lamella joint. This lamella joint is very common in German bridge design, and it is necessary to join flanges with cover plates on the construction site. The detail is characterized by the so-called end groove weld. You can see it in the picture on the lower right side. It is the red marked inner weld of the joint. In the recent years, there were a number of fatigue tests carried out at the University of Stuttgart. These investigations included series with different shapes and thicknesses up to 160 millimeter overall thickness of the joint. The outcome is summarized in the diagram. The fatigue strength of this detail is comparable to common butt joints when a size effect is taken into account. Please notice that this detail has two potential notches for crack initiation, the weld toe and the inner weld, the earlier mentioned end groove weld. Another detail that is very common in German bridge design but missing in the fatigue detail catalog is the, let's call it, traditionally German version of transverse end weld of cover plates. In Germany, this detail is traditionally produced with thick welds and smooth transition of the weld toes, meaning that the surface will be grinded after welding. In the frame of the research project, we was conducting tests at the University of Stuttgart with different thicknesses and sizes of the weld. For the test specimens, we had three different fabricators with a lot of experience in steel bridge fabrication, and they don't really like this detail because of the great welding effort due to the high weld volume and the post-treatment that is necessary. But the detail, you will see, have a very high fatigue strength. At the end, it was obvious that the fatigue strength is a little bit related to the carefulness of post-treatment. You can find traces of the treatment on all specimens, but wealth tells with very smooth transition showed significant higher fatigue strength. We was also investigating the size effect of this detail. We had test specimens with 20 mm thick plates and specimens with 50 mm thick plates. And as you can see it in the diagram, there was no significant influence of the plate thickness. For deriving a fatigue strength for this traditionally German version of transverse end wells of cover plates, we was evaluating all the test data together and also add data from the database. As you can see it in the diagram, the characteristic fatigue strength at 2 million cycles refers to 86 Newton per square millimeter. So we can recommend a fatigue detail category 80. The fatigue detail category for this simple detail with an all-around fillet weld and without post-treatment, which is part of the fatigue detail catalog, is classified with fatigue detail category 56 and worse. The implementation of this new detail opens up opportunities for use this detail in bridge construction. The high fatigue strength of this detail is not only proven by the fatigue tests, but also by practice. The German railroad uses this detail since nearly 100 years, and as far as I know, there are no cases of fatigue damage. Let me sum up the main points of the presentation. I presented a database for fatigue test data to collect information about fatigue tests. This database is a very useful tool for meta studies on fatigue strength. I presented a statistical approach to derive fatigue strength from scattering data that meets the requirements of Eurocode NOT. As an example, I presented studies on two common details, gusset plates and butt joints, and conclude that the fatigue strength of these details could be improved. Based on new tests, I presented proposals for the classification of constructional details that are new for the fatigue detail catalog, the lamella joint and the end well of cover plates. The research work will continue in a follow-up project with focus on influence from size, production and tolerance. And the database should also continue to be filled with fatigue test data. Let me say thank you to our supporters and funders and our research partners. This brings me to the end of my presentation. Let me say thank you for listening and thank you for your attention. And I'll be glad to answer any of your questions. Thank you and goodbye.